Hey artists, welcome to another video in my 30 paintings in 30 days challenge. This is the 13th one, which means we are seeing another lion. Now this was a pretty fun painting. It feels different than the rest. It feels like a lot more of a sort of chaotic energy, a little more rebellion, and hey, that's always a fun thing. So one thing I wanted to talk about today was What do you do when you have art block? And maybe if we're talking to some non-artists here or very new artists who are like, I don't know what art block is. Well, it's kind of the same thing as writer's block, where you just, for the life of you, you cannot come up with any new ideas. You just feel stuck, and it's pretty frustrating. We've all been there at some point where you really want to create something, but you have no ideas. Now, if you always wait for inspiration to strike you before you actually sit down and create something, you might be waiting for a long time. That is one of the biggest roadblocks for, you know, new artists, because they think that art should only be a thing that is created under, you know, a huge burst of inspiration. And when you don't really have any ideas, you could just wait until a new idea hits you. But the thing is that it makes it very difficult to improve and grow as an artist unless you push through those art block moments. So one of my favorite things to do when I am having sort of an art block moment is stuff like this, where I do quick and dirty studies of things that I really like painting. And although this particular series I am having a lot more fun with, I'm not, by no means is this straight up animal realism. This is fun, and there's abstract elements, and it's impressionistic, and that's what I wanted out of the series. But one of my favorite and most effective ways to essentially crush and push through an art block is by doing studies. So picking a subject that you really enjoy, that you want to get better at, for me, it's usually animals. And basically just kind of almost going on autopilot, removing the creative aspect from it, and just doing a study for the sake of learning. Maybe you are kind of studying shapes or colors or textures or composition or form. There's so many different things. So focus on that one particular thing that you're working on, rather than coming up with a brand new shiny idea that's gonna rock the world. That's a lot of pressure to put on yourself. And especially if you are kind of stuck in an art block, sometimes we just need to push our way through it, and kind of creating those more autopilot paintings, maybe, where you're not really focusing on creativity, you're simply focusing on skills. That is one of my favorite ways to move past it. And before long, you are gonna hit that big inspiring streak, and you're gonna feel super like reinvigorated and excited to create some brand new artwork. And because you actually pushed through that art block and focused on improving your skills in the meantime, you're gonna be better off for it. And if you ask me, that's a pretty beautiful thing. So next time you are feeling an art block coming on, you don't really feel creative, you don't know what to create, you're stuck, try doing a study of sorts. Pick one of your favorite subjects and almost sort of release your expectations of what it's going to be like, because you're not going for a masterpiece here. You are simply studying, but you're also creating something for the sake of pushing through that art block, if that makes any sense. And when you put a lot of expectations on yourself for, you know, nailing that piece, making sure it's a masterpiece, even though you aren't really feeling yourself, that's a lot of pressure. So release that pressure and enjoy the process of doing that study, and before long, you are going to be feeling all those creative juices flowing again. Alrighty, so that brings us to the end of this video. I love how feisty this lion looks. It just, with purple and like the splatter and the dripping of the paint. Oh, I love the way this one looks. It was so much fun. Well, thank you guys so much for watching, and we will see you in the next video.